The Four Wheel Drive Show is proudly brought to you by our awesome sponsors at 4x4 and More, Osborne Park, and Northern Four Wheel Drive Centre in Wangara, both helping us take you off-road. Hello and welcome to the Four Wheel Drive Show. This week the team are at McCallum Park in Perth, checking out the Four Wheel Drive and Adventure Show. And Chloe catches up with Big Pete to see how his big rig has turned out. So sit back, relax, flip out the drink holder and let some air out of the tyres, because you're watching the Four Wheel Drive Show and we're taking you off-road.
Welcome to the Four Wheel Drive Show. This week's episode, we check out the Perth Four Wheel Drive and Adventure Show down at McCallum Park. Grizz catches up with Big Pete to see how the Cruiser 60 Series is going in its build-up. But first up, let's go and check out all the action at the Four Wheel Drive Show.
Well, it's that time of year again where the crew decided to head on down to McCallum Park to check out the Four Wheel Drive and Adventure Show. Lots of things to see and do, so let's go have a look. I'm here with Jim from West Coast Suspensions. Welcome along, Jim.
Hello, mate.
Now, West Coast Suspensions, mate, obviously you deal with suspension stuff. What else do you deal with?
We mainly deal with suspensions for like 4x4s and a little bit of truck work, but the last couple of years we've got into a few accessories like rooftop tents and some bar work, and you know, a bit of recovery equipment as well, just to sort of help fill the range out a little bit. So still early days on that, but mainly suspension, but you know, picking it up slowly as we go along.
And whereabouts are you located?
Our workshop's in Bassendean, 188 Railway Parade, Bassendean, and we run a couple of fitting bays down there, so we actually fit suspensions up in-house and still do quite a lot of our own manufacturing and R&D and gear down there as well.
Right, now we're here at the Four Wheel Drive Show. How's this going for you?
Mate, it's been gangbusters today. It's been busy as this morning, so it's probably been one of the busiest shows we've had for Friday yet. So no, it's been really good.
And you've got two more days to go.
Well, I haven't. The boys are doing two more days. But no, it's been a good turnout. It always is. I think we've been here from day one when it was a couple of deck chairs and an umbrella sitting out in the paddock. So,
yeah.
But no, it's been a good day today. We've had some really solid inquiries and quite a few suspension quotes and quite a few sales. So no, it's been good. It's been really good.
So now, with your suspension components, you said you do a bit of in-house work. Do you, like, you retension the springs and stuff like that, or?
Yeah, we do. We can do resets and repairs. We do quite a lot of work for the mining industry, so we're actually doing GVM upgrades on most of your site vehicles now as well.
Oh yeah. Yep.
Like your patrols and your Land Cruisers. But we also obviously supply quite a bit of gear in the recreational 4x4 market.
Yep.
And we've just recently put in a row rig dyno machine, so we're actually dynoing a lot of shocks now, whether it's speedway, track cars or competition stuff too. So.
And how does that work? It's like a shaker or something?
Yeah,
or?
It's actually a dyno, so you mount the shock in the machine and it gives you the valve codes and the damping forces for the shock.
Oh, yeah.
We had to put it in when we were designing our own shock range to make sure we had it right. And we also use it for getting our pound rating on our coils and that sort of thing. So it's been a pretty good little bit of equipment, that.
Good on you.
Yeah.
Well, there you go. And how long have you been around?
The company's actually been going since 1924.
1924?
Yeah.
Well, you don't look that old.
No, I haven't been around quite that long myself, mate. But it started off in St George's Terrace, actually, and it was a service station that pumped gas and did a lot of axle work and that sort of thing. And so probably about the 50s or 60s it really moved into suspension for trucks and four-wheel drives.
Right.
And it's still going since then.
And you've been in the trade for how long?
I've been in it for 30 years this year.
30 years.
Started as an apprentice smithy, so I'm actually a blacksmith by trade.
And okay.
We worked on the furnaces, still pulling, which as we do now, still pulling hot steel and making our own leaf springs. So, yeah.
Good on you.
Pretty good.
Well, there you go. This is Jim from West Coast Suspensions. Now, they're located down in Bassendean, or Bayswater, was it?
In Bassendean.
Bassendean,
yeah.
Yep. So pop down and see them for all your suspension needs and some aftermarket parts for your vehicle.
Right.
Cheers, mate. Much
Thanks
appreciated.
Much. All right, cheers, fellas.
All right, now I've got Amanda with me today. Now, Amanda, you've organised the show. Tell me, what's it all about?
Basically, we put together a show with four-wheel drives, accessories, caravan and camping, pretty much anything to do with travelling around Australia and the great outdoors.
Yeah. And how many people do you expect to come through?
We get on average 25,000 to 30,000 a year. We were up on numbers yesterday and it looks like we're up again today. So we're looking forward to welcoming a record crowd this year.
Yeah, there's a lot of people here checking out all the exhibits. Now, what else apart from four-wheel drives is here that people can check out?
Pretty much anything. We've got tours, we've got destinations, we've got a lot of tourism sites this year. We've also got a lot of caravans, off-road campers. The industry is just huge over here at the moment. So anything you could possibly think of to do with travelling around Australia, it's here.
Yep. And you've also got some four-wheel drive people doing some things over there?
Yes, we've got the Extreme Boys back here again. It's a great draw card for the show. Basically, we get these drivers volunteer their cars and their time to put on a show for the patrons here. Unfortunately, the competitions here in Perth, they're all fairly far away, so they don't get to show off in front of the crowds. So this is their opportunity to do that.
Yeah, this is their chance. So we'll back again next year then?
Absolutely, same time, middle of November next year as well.
Yeah. Okay, cool. Looking forward to then. Thanks for your time, Amanda.
Tonight, what's the dealio? I love when it's all too much. 5 a.m. turn the radio up. Where's the rock and roll? Party crasher, penny snatcher. Call me up if you a gangster. Don't be fancy, just get dancy. Why so serious? So raise your glass if you are.
We're at the four-wheel drive show with Aaron from Coastal 4x4. How are you finding the show, Aaron?
Yeah, very good. Very busy today. A lot more numbers than I thought there'd be.
That's
so
good.
It's been a good turnout.
Yep. And what sort of stuff have you got here for people? Any good specials?
Yeah, we got lots of stuff here for tourers to your hardcore guys, but pretty much everything here is on special.
Yep.
So it's a great opportunity to come in and get a bit of a bargain and save a few dollars.
Bargain's always good.
It is, especially when four-wheel drive accessories are fairly expensive.
So. Well, that's right, that's right.
You know, get into one of the shows and pick up something for a little bit cheaper than normal.
And if people can't catch you here, they can catch you down at Jandakot?
Catch us down at Jandakot. We've got a nice big showroom and workshop down there. So obviously business as usual next week, but whatever can't be found here can definitely be found down there. So
good stuff.
Yep.
No worries then. We're at Coastals and we'll see you next place.
Okay, I got Tim with me from WA Campers. Now Tim, what's it all about?
Basically, we're just here trying to get our name out again. We had a bit of a lull in the beginning of the year and we're just out trying to get the campers going again. So.
Yep. And now all you do is specialise in camper trailers?
Camper trailers, camping equipment. We do a little bit of four-wheel drive due to the fact that we're inside the Office Lock Midland store.
Okay, and what would you say is the most popular camper trailer?
It kind of varies, really. I mean, we've got a couple of different configurations, so it's just more of aimed at your family setups and just goes that way.
Okay, awesome. Thanks for your time, Tim.
No problems. Thank you.
And see you next time.
Cheers.
Well, today I'm here with Alan Gray from Terrain Tamer. Alan, why are you here today?
Why am I here today? Get a bit of your nice sunshine?
Oh, well, yeah, we can't knock that.
Have a look at a decent four-wheel drive show. It's magic. Yeah. It's an area, unbelievable.
It's a pretty decent sized show.
And we're pretty pleased with our setup here. We've got a lot of people coming into the place. We sell the Terrain Toma product. Obviously, you've got it here behind
me. Obviously.
We got this Flash Loop products over here that people are interested.
Yep.
We're not really in competition with many other people because we have so many hard parts.
Yes.
We probably shift $1 million worth of parts a month out of West Melbourne.
Yep.
All over Australia, and now we're in France, of course. And
in France? Yeah. I hadn't heard that.
Yeah, big, big interest in France. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, and I'm sort of pushing the Terrain Toma side of things. Write for a magazine, question and answer.
Yes.
And I find that's interesting. I get a lot of information and stuff from people who come in and talk to me.
Now, that magazine would be four-wheel drive action.
Ah, yeah.
Yes, it would be.
Yeah. Well, there's custom four-wheel drives as well.
Yes.
They're sort of combined the two. And we do DVDs, which come out, as you know, once a month.
Yeah.
And actually, we're doing a DVD on Monday and Tuesday here with the film crew.
Yes.
And I look forward to that. We're trying to make them informative and humorous and collectible. So as people, and a lot of people come in today and say, hey, watch your DVDs. One lady said to me, I spend more time with you in my bed than my husband, in the bed than my husband, because I sit and watch you every night. You know, I can't believe it.
Well, you've got to enjoy that.
So, yeah, but it's very interesting, and we learn a lot because all these new ideas, sometimes I don't know, so I've got to go and ring up and, you know, find somebody. And so many people come in,
yeah.
Very intelligent people. Particularly in Perth, I find that because a lot of people live out, a long way out,
yes.
Not like Melbourne where there's sort of a lot of local people, these guys are really finding problems and finding answers to them, and it's been great. Even today, I had three people who brought up some subjects that I really hadn't thought about, problems that perhaps we don't find in down the east. Well, it was great. I was chatting my head off. In fact, I haven't sold much. I've been
too busy talking. Yeah. You have been in the industry for a huge amount of time.
I worked out the other day, or somebody did, that I've been a mechanic for 62 years.
Oh, no way.
Yeah,
so. Far out. Well, I wouldn't have said you're a day over 60.
Thanks for that.
Now, also, the rumour is that you worked on the very first Land Cruiser.
Yeah, that's the rumour is I worked on the first Land Cruiser. The problem is that people thought I worked on it when it got here. But I worked on it after it got here, but it was one of the first that came.
Yeah.
So East Toyota have got that vehicle. It's at Tarrant Point. And we brought it out one time, and we took it to Seymour down in Victoria, and we all had to drive it, and it gave a bit of trouble, and we worked on it then, and I've worked on it since then. But they've got it back there in their museum. But Ampol Petroleum,
yes.
they had some of the first, and I think how they got them, I reckon they bought them in from their oil fields overseas.
Yes.
I reckon they probably bought them through other places. And they had 4-speed gearboxes, single-speed transfer case, 700 wheels, and the lever to shift the transfer case was often on the dashboard, a big lever that pulled out of the dashboard. And some of them, the ones that I worked on, had steering column gear shifts.
Yes.
Yeah, that's getting back a fair way.
That is going back a fair way.
But what I liked about Land Cruisers is that they were blooming unchanged for years and
yeah.
years, virtually. And it was sad to see the shape go.
Yeah.
Finozzo and I often thought we should have put in a thing like they did in the ashes in the paper. Sad to see the shape go, because you could see them miles away.
Yeah.
And now they're just all the same. Patrol or Suzu, whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah, but anyway, it's been great to be here and meet so many people, and all nice people.
Now, you have got your Ask Alan...
Ask Alan competition on, where you punch up Terrain Toma on the internet,
yes.
And it's got Ask Alan, and you send your queries into us as a contest, and I pick out, now we've had 400 inquiries just about now, and I've got to pick out, in conjunction with the four-wheel drive, 4x4 Action magazine, suitable things for a DVD.
Yes.
So it has a wide range of interest, not just one little thing that we can spend perhaps 3 or 4 hours fixing. And so as the guy's happy, he's won the competition, we give him some gifts. And in the past, they've been absolutely wrapped. I don't know why, but it's just so exciting.
It works.
Yeah.
People love it. I know I enjoy watching the episodes. So if people want to send you something and ask you a question, where do they send it to?
Terrain Toma, Alan Gray, Kerrick, Terrain Toma. And I'll get it somehow.
You'll get it somehow.
Yeah, so, yeah, but the main thing is that people should feel free to not only give me ideas, to ask me questions, and keep me busy.
Why not? Exactly.
So yeah, we're busy. I've done. We've got 14 DVDs to do, and it's a new concept. But from that, other things might develop. We might go into an educational thing about, say, what to do if something happens, or how to handle this. Just some sort of a thing where it might develop into an ongoing sort of thing. Particularly the question and answer thing that I'm doing now for the Custom 4x4 magazine.
Yeah.
That's good, because I can sort sort the questions out as people want them and answer a block of people with perhaps one answer.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, so it's good.
It's been absolute pleasure having you on today, Alan.
Okay.
Thank you very much for your time.
No worries.
And I'm hoping we'll catch you around soon.
Oh, I'll be around for a while. Yeah,
excellent. Thank you very much.
Many things to do yet.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
All right, mate. Thank you.
Now, as you guys know, we've had a competition running for the last 5 weeks, and that was to win yourself a 2-inch suspension lift, which was kindly sponsored by West Coast Suspension. Now, we announced the winner last week, and that was Brad McRae. Unfortunately, Brad couldn't actually get down here today to meet Jim himself, but there you go. Well done, Brad.
No worries, mate. Just give us a call when you're ready, and we'll sort you out.
There we go. All give right. him a ring. Otherwise, cheers. You'll miss out. I'll take it.
All right.
Okay, mate. Cheers for that.
All the best.
Very much.